And now we will learn how to record rent that we actually earned. This means creating invoices. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. We make an invoice after we earn the rent. This is how earned income is recorded into QuickBooks. And that's because in a normal business, the invoice would be a request for payment after the product or service has been delivered. When we create an invoice in QuickBooks, it actually serves two functions. First, it records and acknowledges that we have actually earned the income. And the second function of the invoice would be to make a request for payment and actually have a document that we can print and hand to the tenant. So, first, we will record that we have earned only at the moment we have earned it, which is actually at the end of the month, and we'll discuss that in a moment. But then we will give a document to the tenant for a request for payment for a future month. Now, regarding giving a document to the tenant, we'll talk about that in the video that follows this one. The rest of this video is just making invoices to record that we acknowledge that we earned the rent. In fact, in many cases, we don't even make an invoice. We just record that we earned the rent, and it's very rare we have to print one and give it to a tenant. We did not earn the rent until the end of the month. The invoice date, therefore, must always be the last day of the month that the tenant stayed. Since most tenants pay before staying anyway, you can give them a paid invoice. And again, we will learn in a later video how to get QuickBooks to mark the invoice as acknowledged and stamped as paid. So what will actually happen at the end of the month at the moment we record this invoice? Well, at the end of the month, we can acknowledge and record that we earned rental income. So that number will go from zero up and it will increase. But the unearned amount, that actually the amount we earned during the month, will make unearned rental income decrease by the amount we actually earned. That's because if a month went by, then some of what the tenant paid for, we actually earned. So that's what will happen. Rental income will show up for the first time, and unearned rental income will go down when we make our first invoice. For example, on January 30th, or really supposed to be January 31st, we need to make an invoice for Alan to acknowledge the rent that we have earned during January. Remember, he is the only one that pays $2,000 per month. So what will happen in the trial balance when we record an invoice for Alan for the very first month that he actually stayed? Well, we know that here are the numbers after the previous video, after receiving the rent from only two tenants, Alan being one of them. Now, we know that unearned rental income is going to decrease by the amount that he paid and become $16,000, because $2,000 of the previous $18,000 we just earned during January. But the rental income actually earned is an account in the chart of accounts that will show up for the first time in the trial balance as $2,000. And to top it off, in Alan's specific records, his balance then becomes $10,000. Let's take a look. So to create an invoice, you click the plus sign the way you would for most any transaction, then go all the way to the column on the left that deals with tenant-related transactions, and click Invoice. And the invoice window opens up. And it's very simple to complete the invoice window. First, click the Customer pull-down menu, scroll down to the customer we want, and click. And we have Alan Arby in A1. Now, click here and go back to the date that we're actually making the first invoice. January 31st is the end of the first month whose rent that we actually earned. And of course, we click directly under the word product or service just to bring the pull down arrow. Now, when we click the arrow, we notice all of the items that we learned about in the prior video are listed here in the pull down menu, and we click rent due. And in the case of Alan, we put 2000 because his rent is 2000 per month. Now, when we click save to acknowledge that we recorded our first invoice for Alan, and again, you don't have to show this message. Click OK. Oh, let's don't show this message again. Click OK. Now, when we come here to the reports, the results are exactly as we expected. Reports, custom, trial balance. Notice unearned rental income has decreased because there's less unearned, and rental income earned has shown up for the first time in the trial balance as $2,000. We can also click reports, tenant balance detail, and we can see that only Alan's balance has decreased by $2,000 and it is now down to $10,000. Now in QuickBooks Online, the better report, it turns out, is really the transaction list by customer. It does what the balance detail is supposed to do. And we're going to change the transaction list by customer to read transaction list by tenant. QuickBooks Online, for some reason, is very different than the QuickBooks desktop version, and this report is only slightly helpful. The better report is where you click reports, standard, and then scroll down to where it says sales and customers, and click this last one, transaction list by customer. If we change the date pull down to read all, you can, and then run the report, click run the report, you can see that it's actually giving you each individual transaction, and then it gives you the balance at the bottom. Now, that's not as good as having the running balance the way the desktop version allows you to see the balance at any given moment in time. But the video that will follow this one is a supplemental video that shows how to export this to Excel and type in a formula to get the running balance, and that would be the balance at any particular moment. But let's just save this with the name Transaction List by Tenant. So we click the pencil tool, just like we learned last time, and change the word customer to the word tenant. Oops, well, we don't want to do the opposite of capitals. So we change it to tenant, and of course, click away from the field, and that would save it. And now when we click Save Customization, we also change the name on the report. Oh, it actually knows that we want it to be called Transaction List by Tenant because we changed it in the title. So when we click Save, we can check that if we click Reports, Custom Reports, we can get Transaction List by Tenant, and we can see every payment and every invoice, and we can see what the current balance is for each tenant. Now let's do a second example. Let's imagine, again, on January 31, we made another invoice, this time for candy, to acknowledge the rent that we have earned during January for candy. Now remember, she only pays $1,000 a month. So, can we predict what will happen? Well, this is the way the trial balance looks before we record this next transaction. Can you predict what the numbers will be? If we have less unearned because another month went by, that means unearned goes down by the amount of rent for that month. So unearned rental income will become $15,000. And the rental income earned will increase this time and become $3,000. So we have $1,000 less of unearned and $1,000 more of rental income earned after we record Candy's first invoice. And of course, in a separate area of records, Candy's balance becomes $5,000. Let's take a look. So again, we click the plus sign for every possible type of transaction, go all the way to the left for tenant-related transactions, and again click invoice. This invoice again is dated January 31 because it acknowledges that we earned the rent at the end of the month from this specific tenant. Scroll down, scroll up. Here she is, Candy Charles. Good. Now, we click under the word product and service to bring the arrow, click on the arrow, and click rent due. And for Candy, it's only $1,000. Push tab. Now, we click save. And then, of course, when we close it, we can check the results. We click report. Well, right here in the transaction list by tenant, you can see that this $1,000 invoice has been added to Candy's section, and it adjusts her balance accordingly. The balance obviously is not correct because it's indicating everything as positive. So that's why you also need the tenant balance detail as well. But if you click reports and then you click trial balance, you can see that the numbers in the trial balance are exactly as what we predicted after this transaction. And then if you click reports and then you click tenant balance detail, you can see that Candy's actual balance is down to $5,000 and Alan's actual balance is down to $10,000. And of course, I want to stress again what I had stressed before in the previous video. You can fix any transaction that you recorded by simply opening the report, double-clicking the transaction, and changing it to what you want. Just to remind you, if we click reports, and we went back to the trial balance is a summary. And that means if we double-click any summary number, we get the details of each transaction that led up to that total number. Or we would if it allowed us to scroll. I don't know why. But if we wanted to change one, for example, if this invoice was wrong for $1,000, if I double-click and I say, I don't want this to be $1,000, I want it to be $1 billion. Or whatever that is, okay? A big, huge, ridiculous number, the most QuickBooks can handle. We click save, click yes. If I change this right now, and I go back to reports, trial balance, you can see the trial balance has crazy numbers. I could also click reports and see that on the transaction list by tenant. I can see I have this crazy number. But if I double click from any report, if I open the transaction from any report, I go back to the original window that I entered it, change it to what it's supposed to be, then click save, click yes. Soon as I save the change, the results in the reports immediately fix themselves and the numbers go back to the way they're supposed to be.